Hello students, welcome to my class. Today I am going to explain you the transformation of scalars, vectors under rotation. So as it is rotating in a clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, so what are the transformation of scalars and vectors? Does scalars vector changes its value? That we are going to see. Okay, so for that let us consider. First one is transformation of scalars under rotation. Okay, so I would like to explain first one. In the second one, let us see transformation of vectors under rotation. Yes, shall we start? Yes. Before going to explain, please do subscribe my channel for the more updates, and do like, share, okay, and send this topic for many of your friends so that you can enjoy the law of physics. Now let us see. A quantity which has magnitude but not direction is called scalar quantity. This is the definition of scalar. Okay, let us consider a car is moving on a road. A car is moving on a road. The distance traveled by a car is a scalar quantity. Yes, distance is an example for scalars. And a car travels as a distance of 1000 meters in xy plane. Okay, let us see the diagram now. And this is the x direction, y direction. Car is moving along the x direction. So car is travels 1000 meters. Okay, and as this plane, xy plane, is rotates like this, as it is rotating like this, as it is rotating like this, we'll get this x dash and y dash frame, x dash and y dash frame. And this along x dash frame, there is a 1000 meters distance, okay, traveled by the car. And this distance never changes, even the xy plane rotates, okay. And because it is a distance traveled by the car is a scalar quantity, it doesn't change its value, so that we can consider or conclude the distance traveled is the same when it reaches in xy plane and on x dash y dash plane. Hence scalar quantity remains unchanged under its rotation. Scalar quantity remains unchanged under its rotation. So these two examples tells us the transformation of scalars under rotation is unchanged. Now let us see second one is transformation of vectors under rotation. So that if what is the definition of the vectors? A quantity which has both magnitude and direction is called a vector quantity. Now let us try to understand. This is the graph which is plotted from origin, that is x and y axis. So a car is moving 800 meters along x direction and it is moving 600 meters along y direction. 800 meters along x direction, 600 meters along y direction. Now, so what in that case, what is the distance? Simply 800 plus 600, 1400 is the distance. To find the displacement, we need to form a triangle like this. Okay, this is the displacement. From initial to final is the displacement. This is the displacement. So here, see the second diagram I have explained here, and this xy plane is rotated in a clockwise direction, sorry, in an anti-clockwise direction, then x dash and y dash is coming here, okay, and this is the triangle is made, and this along x axis 800 meters traveled by car and along y axis 600 meters traveled by the car, and this is the distance, this is a radius vector, we can consider radius vector. So this is a displacement, okay, can be found by taking what? That is Pythagoras theorem, okay, by using Pythagoras theorem we can find the displacement. Now let us see the total distance traveled by the car is 1400 meters, yes, in xy plane. that is 800 meters plus 600 meters is equal to 1400 meters. But the net displacement is a vector is 1000 meters. How can we get this? Let us see. This is a triangle, right angle triangle. This is along y-axis 600 meters covered, along x-axis 800 meters covers, and this is hypotenuse. So according to Pythagoras, hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus height square, then hypotenuse is equal to square root of base square plus height square. So that is 600 square, this is height and this is base. So after doing this mathematical form, we get 1000 meters. We get 1000 meters. If you want to see, so just pause the video and you go through that mathematical calculation. To find the angle, we know that tan inverse is equal to y by x. Y is the vertical distance or vertical plane, and this is horizontal plane. Y by x and tan inverse, y nothing but along vertical y axis there is a 600 by 800, 0 gets cancelled, 6 by 8 and 2 3 is a 2 4 is a. So angle equal to tan inverse 3 by 4, this is angle theta. Angle theta is equals to tan inverse 3 by 4. So the displacement of a vector 1000 meters at which angle tan inverse of 3 by 4, this angle there is a displacement takes place. Now in xy plane the distance is unchanged. It can be seen from figure 2, and the vector components x dash, y dash and are different. So this is already we have discussed in the diagram. Now let us see. So how the vectors transformed? The transformation of vectors can change under its rotation. How it is changes, let us see. So this is the diagram which tells us, and this is a x dash, y dash, and x axis, y axis, this is x dash and this is y dash, this is a, let us consider this is O, is OB is a base which travels 800 meters, that is, let us consider AX. Here listen to me, AX is equal to OB, and this is AB, AB is equal to AY, So this is OA is a vector in that case. From figure 3, OA is a vector with components. This vector can changes under its rotating, under its rotation. That components we are going to see. Clear? Let us see, A, C, B, and this is normal. If I draw the normals here, this is what B and B dash. This is normal to X dash, and this is the normal to X dash, and this AD represents Y dash. AD represents Y dash. Now, and this is the normal. And this is normal to x dash. All are normal to x dash. Let us do some. Ax is equal to OB. Ax is equals to O and B. Ay is equals to AB. Ay is equals to AB. This is AB, which is equals to Ay, component of A along y direction. Ax dash is equal to what? This is x dash axis. And Ax dash. A x dash is equals to O A. This is what? O and A dash. O A dash represents what? A x dash. And A y dash is equal to what? A y dash. This is the y dash, What is the component? And this is the component. This one. From here to here is the A y dash. A y dash. A dash. A y dash is equal to A dash. Now consider, this is very important components to understand the this diagram. Now consider AX dash is equal to OA dash. AX dash is equals to, let us consider OA dash. So OA dash is where? O and this is A dash. And this one we can write, O B dash plus B A dash. OB dash plus BA dash. That's why I have written OB dash plus BA dash. And this BA dash, BA dash, again we can write B dash C plus CA dash. B dash C plus CA dash. Listen to me. So that's why you can write this is B dash A dash. We can write B dash C plus CA dash. Okay. Now, so to get this component, listen to me, it's very, very important. So what is OB dash? OB dash, this is the OB dash. This is angle and this is, okay, perpendicular. And this, if it is angle, this is opposite side. Okay, we have to get this value. This is opposite, this is adjacent. So if it is, we have to find this adjacent so that we have to find the OB. Here we have to take the cos theta. Here cos theta is equals to what? This is cos theta is equals to OB by OB dash by OB. So cos theta is equals to, if it is, this is angle, opposite, adjacent, okay, adjacent by hypotenuse. Cos theta is equals to adjacent. This is cos theta. Let us find out. Is equal to, yes. Okay, cos theta is equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent is OB dash, hypotenuse is OB. Okay, then OB dash is equal to OB cos theta. It's clear, OB cos theta. Here, write an OB cos theta. Now, let us see B dash C. Where is B dash C? B dash C. Okay, this one, this triangle you take. And this is the angle, this is opposite side. Okay, this is opposite side. So that we have to find this opposite side. So that we have to take sin theta. So that here, listen to me. Sin theta is equals to B dash C by BC. Sin theta nothing but this is opposite by adjacent. Opposite by adjacent. Sorry, opposite by hypotenuse. This is opposite, this is adjacent, this is hypotenuse. So opposite, that is B dash C by hypotenuse, that is BC. So then B dash C is equals to what? B dash C is equal to BC sin theta. So this is going this side. Now, this is okay, BC sin theta. Next, we have to find CA dash, CA dash, CA dash. So to find CA dash, again we have to take what triangle? CA dash, this triangle we have to take. This is angle, this is opposite side, okay? And we have to take CA dash, CA, this one we have to take. So that we have to take again sin theta. Sin theta is equals to what? Sin theta is equal to this one, that is opposite, opposite side by hypotenuse. That is CA. This one by this one. So CA dash by CA. Then CA dash is equal to CA sin theta. CA sin theta. So this is OB cos theta plus this is sin theta common. So after taking common BC plus CA into sin theta, and OB cos theta plus BC plus CA. BC plus CA is equal to AB. Once you see B plus BC plus CA. This one plus this one. Okay, this one plus this one equal to what? AB. AB. That is AB, which is equals to Y. AY. Now listen to me, Nana. Okay, here what is OB? OB is AX and AB is AY. So that we can write AX cos theta plus AY sin theta. This is AX dash equal to. Similarly, the component AY dash can be written as, this is what? AX dash component. We can write AY dash component. What is the AY dash component? So AY dash is equals to AA dash. AA dash. Then we can write AA dash, this one we can write from this total AD minus A dash D. From this total we have to subtract this, then we'll get this one. So that we can write it as, okay, AD minus A dash D will get a dash. A dash. So from that AD minus AD, A dash D. Then AD is AD, A dash D which is equals to BB dash, because this is a rectangular. A dash D, this side, which is equals to this side, B dash B. So that BB dash. Okay, and what is AD? To find this AD, and AD is where? A is this one, D is this one. So we have to take this triangle here now. This triangle. In that, this is angle, this is opposite side. Okay, if it is opposite side, and this is hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse. Now, I'm taking this is in that, write down. Okay, so AD, AD minus A dash D, AD minus BB dash, and AB cos theta. How can we get this AB cos theta? To find this AD, we have to take this one, B, AD, B, this triangle. In that triangle, okay, so that is cos theta is equals to AD by AB. We have to find AD. AD is this one, this is adjacent, this is opposite. So if you take the cos theta, adjacent by hypotenuse, AD by AB. That is, I have written AD by AB, and AD is equals to AB cos theta. And this one finish. AB cos theta. Now let us find out BB dash. Where is BB dash? BB dash, and this triangle we have to take. This triangle. So in that, BB dash, if it is angle, this is opposite, we have to take sin theta here. Clear? Sin theta here. And that is opposite by hypotenuse. This is BB dash by OB. Sin theta is equal to BB dash by OB. BB dash is equal to OB sin theta. Okay, and OB sin theta. AB nothing but AY. AB nothing but AY. Okay, and OB nothing but AX. AX. Then we can find AY cos theta minus AX sin theta. That is, AY dash is equals to minus AX sin theta. This one written here, and this one I am writing here. So these are the vector components along X dash axis and Y dash axis. So if a vector is seen from a frame rotated about Z axis, angle theta, about Z axis, if we see a vector is rotating about Z and we are watching from there, then in that case XY components in X dash Y dash frame are written in the like this. Okay, AX dash is equal to these two equations, we have got it, and AZ dash is equal to AZ, because the vector is rotating about this Z axis, about Z axis only they are unchanged, about Y axis, Y axis unchanged, about X axis, X axis unchanged. So remaining all are, we'll get the some transformation of vectors. So this is about the vectors, transformation of vectors under its rotation. Under its rotation. So thank you for watching this class. So please do subscribe my channel for the more updates. Okay, thank you. Bye.